In the late 1980s and early 1990s, more than 2 million Australians would tune in to watch Don Burke share his love of gardening. His hands, black with earth, would wave about as he explained the properties of some flower or fern, one elbow resting on the spade he'd used to dig the hole beside his feet. As we learned Monday morning, it seems he'd been digging a much larger one all along. A stunning joint investigation by Fairfax Media and the ABC presented allegations by dozens of men and women that the popular television presenter had sexually harassed, bullied and intimidated employees during his time as host of Channel 9 lifestyle juggernaut Burke's Backyard. But why now? Why did it take 3 decades for rumors to turn into headlines? Protecting an asset? At its most basic level, Burke's alleged behavior occurred out in near-perfect conditions. He was powerful, he was influential, valuable and, because of that, protected. At the height of its success, Burke's Backyard was a ratings winner for Channel 9, and routinely raked in audiences in the high 1 millions, the kind of numbers we'd expect of a blockbuster MasterChef or My Kitchen Rules finale today. Burke himself was estimated by BRW to have earned $7.2 million in 2004, the same year the show was unceremoniously axed over falling ratings after 17 years on the air. Popular richer TV legend. An OAM recipient all worked against anyone who tried to come forward, to suggest that he was anything other than Australia's beloved garden guru. According to Kate McClay MOT, reporter behind Monday's Expose, several tried. David Leckie, the former chief executive of the Nine Network, conceded that multiple complaints were made about Burke's behavior, but no action was taken, and Leckie indicated to the Sydney Morning Herald that all complaints he'd heard were second-hand. As researcher Louise Langdon told McClay MOT, there was an institutionalized acceptance of his behavior, and it was actually not just an acceptance, it was an institutionalized enabling. The kind that kept even more women silent out of fear of retribution, both personal and professional. In the words of Tracy Spicer, the journalist who instigated the story, many had internalized society's misogyny, a culture of victim shaming and blaming. So unafraid, so brazen, so untouchable was Burke at the time that he reportedly did even feel the need to censor his behavior in front of press. According to McClay MOT, he allegedly spoke to one young entertainment reporter about sex positions, commented on her breasts, referred to the size of his genitals, even told her he purchased a horse for a young relative because I love watching her rub her C**** on its back. A tape was rolling for that comment. Yet when the journalist delivered the recording to Channel 9 Publicity, her complaint was reportedly met with a bunch of flowers. He was a very, very big star back there, the woman told Fairfax, and I think that's what people need to take into account. In a twisted way, heavyweight Hollywood producer Harvey Weinstein has allowed for Burke's exposure. When the world witnessed that retribution against a harasser of such power and influence was in fact possible, the ground shifted and a tsunami swept across the entertainment industry.